Okay na. So thermometer, temperature na to, applications?
Yes po, sir.
Okay. Sige, start.
Today, didiscuss ko po yung application of different instrumentation related to temperature po. And number one po is yung bimetallic thermometers. Bimetallic thermometer is a temperature measurement device. It converts media temperature into mechanical displacement using bimetallic strip. Yung metal po na gamit dito is common yung steel, copper, and brass. And then, yung strips are connected po and nag-enlarge po sila at different rates pag nagiinitan. And this ano, this metallic, this metal strip po have different thermal expansion coefficient po. And some of applications are bimetallic thermometers are used in residential devices like air conditioners, ovens, and industrial devices like heaters, hot wires, refineries. Next po. And then, ayan po yung itsura ng bimetallic thermometer. May dalawang strip. And yung dalawang strip na yun, magkaiba yung kanyang thermal expansion coefficient. Next. Next. Next, hindi. So, hindi yun. Ano. Next. And may advantage yung bimetallic thermometer.
Ano ang mabilis na nag-expand? Ano ang masasabi mo sa dalawang metal?
Yung dalawang metal po, magkaiba po yun. Property po nila.
Property yun? Thermal?
Yung isa po gamit po siya sa ano, thermal ano po.
Thermal coefficient of thermal expansion. So yung isa mas madaling ano mag-expand no compared sa other. So pwedeng mag-bend 'yon, mag-break or make. 'Di ba? Ama, pag mainit na, mag-expand, mag-break, 'di ba? Kaya 'yun yung mga application ng heater. Ama, ngayon may heater ako eh. Ilang minuto lang, mga dalawa. 'Di ba? Yung parang takore, kettle, sasaksak mo lang. Dati 'di ba LPG, ngayon di kuryente na 'di ba? So it will take some time para ano mabilis lang magbi-break na pag naabot niya na yung temperature na naka-calibrate sa current or sa voltage. Meron ka pa mga sample diyan? Dapat may sample kayo ng applications, ha?
Opo.
Meron ba?
Bigla po sir, nagkaroon ng technical difficulty yung nagpe-present po.
Okay. Sabi ko dagdagan para madaling drawings, pictures. Wala nga tayong labi, so kailangan wala ba yung internet?
Okay na po sir, wait na po.
Ay balik sa ano, sa bimetallic. And yung ano po, yung application po niya is ginagamit po siya sa mga residential device like air conditioners po, ovens and heaters, hot wires and refineries. Next. Then ayan po yung itsura ng bimetallic thermometer and yung property po niya last week is na-discuss na. Next po.
Sige.
Next po yung thermistors. Thermistor is a thermally sensitive ceramic semiconductor which exhibit a change in resistance as temperature changes. Yung thermistors ay tinatawag din ano, thermally sensitive resistors. Kasi po, measure niya po yung ano, yung ambient temperature and nakokontrol niya po yung ano, direct component resistance. And some of its application po, thermistors are used as temperature sensors. They can be found in everyday appliances such as fire alarms, ovens, and refrigerators. And ginagamit din po siya sa mga digital thermometers and any automatic applications. Ayun po yung ano, yung itsura niya po. Is maliit lang po, parang maliit lang po siya na ano, semiconductor.
Sabi dyan sa mga oven, sa
next. Next po is yung thermocouples. Thermocouples are the most widely used temperature sensors due to their combination of wide temperature capabilities and low cost. Yung thermocouple po is tinatawag din po silang ano, thermal junction. Temperature measuring device po, which is consists po siya ng ano, dalawang wires of different metals na naka-join po sila sa dulo. And parang
dalawang metal yan eh, nagtatagpo sa junction. Alam mo ba kung anong reference temperature sa junction?
Hindi po, sir.
Letter yon, mga letter. Bigay mo nga sa akin. Mga type ng thermocouple, depende sa combination ng metal. Pwedeng tungsten, pwedeng yes. Yung ganun. Ano yung mga types ng thermocouple? Magbigay ka ng may mga letter.
Type K po. Type okay. KJ.
Ano pa?
Yung B po, B. R, M, N po.
Ano dapat nakita mo kung ano pa? Type K, ano yung metal na involved? Halimbawa, tungsten, aluminum. Gusto kong makita kasi wala tayong lab eh. Pag puro letra lang ang ipapakita nyo, tayo hindi makikita ng mga klase mo, diba? Pag gusto ko sana, may mga picture kayo ng thermocouple, anong type, metal lang ginagawa.
No? May isa susunod na slide po meron.
Ah, sige.
And po yung itsura na. And pagbalik mo kanina. And yung application po niya, thermocouple are used in application that range from home appliances to industrial processes to electric power generation to furnace monitoring and control to food and beverage processing to automotive sensors to aircraft engines to rockets, satellites, and spacecraft. Next. Ayun po yung itsura niya. Next po yung resistance temperature detectors o yung RTD po. RTD are temperature sensors that are commonly used in variety of industrial applications including industrial boilers, petrochemical exhaust gas monitoring, and food processing. Yung RTD po is a device po. Ginagamit siya sa electronic, electrical, and mechanical equipment mo. Is parang ginagamit po siya parang various type like voltage, current, and acceleration. And parang concept po yun ng Ohm's law, yung RTD. Kasi po, once na resistance po siya, and once na nag-change po yung resistance, mag-change po din yung temperature. And RTD sensors obey high accuracy po than thermocouples and thermistors. Next po. Ay po yung itsura ng yung RTD. Which is parang same po siya ng thermocouple pero mas maganda pong gamitin po yung yung RTD kaysa thermocouple and thermistors. Next po. Next po is yung radiation pyrometry. Radiation pyrometers are usually calibrated in terms of black body radiation and thus measure what it is known as radiance temperature. Yung gamit po dito is a optical system na nagko-collect po ng visible and infrared energy, which is nade-detect po niya yan. And yung total radiation po coming from a particular hot body po, nade-trace niya po yun. And yung application po niya is it measures temperature of places or components which are not easy to access. It is used to measure average temperature of large surfaces and it is used as to measure temperature of moving object or target. Ayan po yung itsura niya. Next. Next is the infrared sensors. Infrared sensors are non-contacting sensors. These Infrared sensors can detect clouds for remote telescope operation, checking mechanical or electrical equipment for temperature and hotspot, measuring temperature of patient in the hospital without touching them. Ayun po yung itsura. Parang most commonly po, ginagamit po yung sa mga airport nung may, ano, may infection. It's nade-detect niya po yung ano, yung may mga mataas po yung temperature. Next. Next is yung common sa atin, yung thermometer. Thermometer is a device that detects temperature or the temperature difference. Thermometers are frequently used to monitor process in technology and industry as well, as in meteorology, medicine, and scientific study. Po yung common sa atin, yung thermometer, which is ginagamit po natin daily. And this thermometer, ano, have three most common units in measurement, which is yung Celsius, Fahrenheit, and Kelvin. And also, ginagamit din po yung thermometer sa measuring such as solid sa pagkain, sa liquid, sa water, and sa gas, sa air. Also, yung other application na is in the house, automobiles, and industries, and in restaurants. Next. Lastly is yung silicon diode. Silicon diode sensor is a device that has been developed specifically for the cryogenic temperature range. Yung ano po, ginagamit po ito as a variety of moderate precision temperature measurement application. And kilala po siya as cryogenic temperature, ginagamit sa industry. Is nagre-range po siya sa nagre-range yung temperature niya to 1,500 Kelvin to 400,000 Kelvin. And yung application po niya is application na heat engine which converts heat difference directly into electric power, a heat engine working backwards as a refrigerator such as Stirling engine. And some of its advantages po is low cost, accurate and reliable, highly consistent measurement, and some of its disadvantages are heating, low resistance standards, and requirement of additional circuitry to control application loads. Next reporter.
Ano po? Panik po ba? Good afternoon po.
Yes, may kasunod po.
Hello po. Narinig po ba, sir?
Yes.
Next na siya. So, ano pa? Here are sample problems for how to read and measure pressure, volume, and temperature. First po is pressure. A car driver wants to know the tire pressure of its car if it is good. He uses Borden's tube temperature gauge to see what is the reading on the gauge. Dito po sa gauge natin, makikita po natin na meron siyang 20, 40, 60, and 100. So, yung pong pin or yung needle nung gauge is nakatapat after three lines. Nasa gitna po siya ng third and fourth line. So, the measure po of the temperature is 7 PSI. Next yan. 7 PSI po. And next. Dalawa pa rin. So next po is volume. A baker is creating a dough for a bread, and that he's doing. He needs 200 ml of milk for it. He pours milk on the beaker, and what is the volume of the milk? How much does he need to create the dough? Makikita po natin sa beaker na meron po siyang up to 300 ml yung max na masusukan yung volume. Then the milk po is exactly at 200 ml po, which is how much the baker needs to create the dough. Next. Then po is, next po is volume again. In a chemistry class, students are instructed to put exactly 15 ml of the liquid in the graduated cylinder. One of the students puts too much on the graduated cylinder. What is the amount of the liquid he or she put? How much does he needs to lessen to make the volume right? So, nakatakip yung ano. So, makikita natin na yung volume ng liquid is more than dun sa exact amount, which is 15. So, the measure is 16 ml and kailangan niyang bawasan ng 1 ml to make the volume of the liquid exactly dun sa nire-require nung teacher nila. So, yun. Next. Next is temperature. So, ay, hindi yung primary yan. Sorry po. Yan. Yan. In a zoo, the zookeeper is preparing for the arrival of the new attraction, the penguins. He wants to get the temperature of the room where the penguin will be placed. He leaves a thermometer in the room to get the temperature. After a few hours, what is the temperature reading in the room? So, makikita natin dun sa thermometer na yung reading is below 0 degrees and at exactly negative 6 degrees Celsius. Yun lang po. Thank you po, sir.